Hello everyone, welcome to another video. Today I'd like to talk to you a little bit about Reaper. I had a bunch of trouble learning this DAW from the very beginning, not only because it looks different, but also because it performs very differently from Pro Tools, which is the one that I'm most used to. But because I had to learn this on the fly, I started making this huge list right here, which contains some basic custom actions as well as other assignments that would just make my life easier. And what I wanted to do in this video is share all of this with you. I've adapted this to the PC as well, so all of you can benefit from it. And linked in the description, you'll find a PDF in an Excel version of these notes, as well as the Reaper key commands for both Mac and PC, so that you can import them to Reaper and start experimenting. And I also wanted to run through some of the actions so that you can understand a little bit of how Reaper works if you're new to the software. So let's get into it. So whenever you render a new item in Reaper, it's going to place the new one below the original one, such as right here. So the grayed out version is the original. You can check this out right here at the top. So right now I'm selecting take one, and right now I'm selecting take two. To me, this is quite confusing, especially whenever you have more than one take. Fortunately, there is a way that we can bypass this, which is by pressing, in this case, Command L to show all takes in lanes when room. So Command L, and now I'm just visualizing take four, and now take three, two, and one. Next, I wanted to talk to you about automation. So let's say that I put an EQ. Let me just double click this to open just the EQ right here. And the automations lane is located right here. So I'm gonna choose, say, all of the parameters. And I'm gonna put all of the parameters in latch preview. So you can see that it's enabled by turning it yellow. And I'm also gonna disarm all of the parameters from recording by clicking one by one or by hitting Option Shift Dot. So I'm just going to hit play and try to automate. You'll see that nothing is happening because automation is disabled, right? So for you to write automation, you have to have this little square right here checked. So I'm just going to close this and hit Option Dot to arm all of them. And now when I hit play, there it is. And again, Reaper tells you that the parameters are being automated by lighting them red right here, so you can see it. And right now, nothing has been written because of latch preview. So I'm just gonna hit stop, make a selection, and then press Shift Option W to write automation for that selection to all of the active parameters, as you can see. Now I'd like to show you something really cool, which is to copy and paste track routings. For that, you're gonna need the extensions SWS and SNM. But anyways, what you wanna do is just, let's say that I wanna uncheck master send and send it to 3 and 4. So instead of coming here to the first track and manually setting that up, I can simply click the track that I want, hit Command Option Control R, and then come here and paste that with Command Option Control V. And now we have the sends right there. Pretty handy. One very important thing to notice about custom actions is whenever you open the actions window and you come to custom, when you go to edit, it's always better if you have consolidate undo points checked, because whenever you undo an action, instead of undoing twice, you only undo one time. And finally, if you switch a lot between computers, you can export your configurations and import them again later on. And to do that, it's all the way down here under Project, and this one. So let's export this set of configurations and hit Save. Just gonna overwrite it. And then you wait a little bit and it's done. And coming back to the render item section, I have it set up this way because I've got a mouse modifier, which is located under preferences. and then mouse modifiers, media item, double click. So whenever I hold option and double click an item, it's gonna open it in an external editor, and that can be set right here. Then you set up the external editor that you want. So it's always good to render it as a new file, because whenever I send it to Isotope, I can't send it back to Reaper and render the file on top of that file. So the only way to get it back is to alter something right here. Let's say something like this, and then overwrite the original file, which will then be right here. But anyways, that's pretty much it for this video. You can find the links to download the files below. And as always, I wish you have a great day, and I'll talk to you soon. See ya!